young housewife is frightened by a sudden fire. Being a woman, she's in a state of panic and her life is in danger. Luckily, a local boy notices the problem and runs for the nearest call box. The fire extinguishing apparatus is a new development that allows a trained professional to avert disaster. The proper steps in the use of the fire extinguisher can be easily remembered by the familiar word, fudgel. Fetch the fire extinguishing apparatus and approach the conflagration. Upend the apparatus with alacrity. This is no time to be tentative. Lives could be at stake. Direct the hose nozzle towards the base of the fire. Give the involved area a thorough going over. Evacuate the remaining carbonic acid gas by returning the apparatus to an upright position. Look carefully for any remaining flames or embers. Fudgel, a useful word that could save a life. Thanks to this new invention and the swift actions of our local heroic fireman, a young housewife can sleep soundly tonight after she finishes making dinner.
So I recently acquired this soda acid antique fire extinguisher, and a lot of people like to polish these up and use them as decor, but since this one seems to be in working condition, I thought I'd charge it up and try it out. Directions for charging. Fill bottle half full of sulfuric acid, 4 fluid ounces. Place stopper on same and fasten into cage. Dissolve 1.5 pounds bicarbonate of soda into 2.5 gallons of cold water. Pour into extinguisher to filling mark. Screw cap down to washer. Alright, so this is how it works. It's got this little glass bottle that you fill up to that mark with sulfuric acid, and it's got a lead stopper in the top. When you turn the extinguisher upside down, the lead stopper falls out. The sulfuric acid mixes with the sodium bicarbonate and water and produces enough carbon dioxide to propel the water out of this little guy. I should note that the name of this channel, Chemical 14, refers to the fire company Chemical 14, which was once stationed in this building along with Phoenix 8 Pumper. A chemical company was essentially a giant soda acid fire extinguisher with carriage wheels that was hand pulled to the scene of a fire. It could then be activated either by flipping it upside down or sometimes by breaking a glass vial that contained sulfuric acid. I'm not sure how long Chemical 14 was in service here, but this was a fire station until the mid-1960s.
One of our chemist friends suggested that instead of using sulfuric acid, we use hydrochloric acid since it might be a little safer. Both reactions result in carbon dioxide gas, so both will work. The extinguisher calls for 4 ounces of sulfuric acid, so we had to figure out how much hydrochloric acid we needed. One molecule of sulfuric acid reacts with one molecule of sodium bicarbonate to form 2 molecules of carbon dioxide, 2 molecules of water, and 1 molecule of sodium sulfate. One molecule of hydrochloric acid reacts with 1 molecule of sodium bicarbonate to produce 1 molecule of carbon dioxide, 1 molecule of salt, and 1 molecule of water. So, molecule for molecule, the sulfuric acid reaction is twice as efficient as using hydrochloric acid. Using the magic of Avogadro's number and dimly remembered chemistry classes, getting the same reaction from 31% hydrochloric acid as 95% sulfuric acid would require roughly 7 times as much hydrochloric acid. Since the bottle in the extinguisher would only hold about 8 ounces total, at best we'd only be generating about 1/3 as much carbon dioxide. Is this a problem? Probably not for us, since we're just trying to spray some water and not blow the lid off an antique fire extinguisher. I'm sorry.
Thank you.